Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the Star Series C Qualifier. This is TNC taking on Power Gaming in Best of Two Series. I am Luminous, and I'm going to be joined by Aeos and Dota. And we got TNC fresh off their WESG win. Should be one of the top teams. They are currently sitting, I believe, at one draw. One win and one draw at the round robin here at the C qualifier, so they're definitely in a great slot as well to qualify.
I mean, that just means we're going to be seeing a lot of TNC, right?
Yeah, a lot of TNC, a lot more Execration, a lot more Faceless, and a lot more Warrior and Fnatic. Basically, pretty much every team except Mineski, because Mineski has mostly played most of their games.
Slardar is the first pickup. Not surprised, Slardar is such a good hero this patch.
Did you actually get to watch the TNC games for WESG?
Only parts of it.
Okay. Did you pick up
on
any?
It was at such a terrible time, so.
As at the best time.
I wasn't really able to watch.
It's during this time.
Oh yeah, my favorite. Sleeping hours.
Did you pick up any kind of heroes that they like to play, or any particular playstyle that they do?
Not really.
Okay.
I don't really remember too much. WSG feels like such a long time ago.
It's like last week.
But they have so many like playmakers on their team. It's like a lot of fun to watch their team. They seem to like work so well together.
All right. We're kind of slowly going to the second phase. Meepo's in the pool. Is Power Gaming thinking of taking the Meepo? I don't know if they have a Meepo player themselves.
I'm sure every Southeast Asian team has a Meepo player.
Oh, they're not first picking it.
Maybe it's the Timbersaw into... Let's get rid of Timbersaw so we can pick Meepo.
I mean, yesterday they picked Magnus PA against it, so maybe they're like, you could pick Meepo, will Magnus TA against it again?
10 seconds to go.
And Magnus... this time we have Jacko playing the Magnus.
Yeah.
I'm not afraid.
5 seconds.
Are they trying to look for Meepo?
Really taking their sweet time.
Yeah.
And I like that these pick arrows are still going the wrong way.
The game's still in beta, so they're going to fix it soon.
Okay. Is it just me, or is the timer wrong as well?
Dyer's pick. The timer is pointing to the other direction.
Okay, so it was wrong, because they basically had like 10 seconds left, but it showed me the other team's reserve time, and I was like, why do they have 2 minutes left?
Yeah. All right, so Meepo's ignored, dude. Thoughts?
I think this is fine. Both teams are... They kind of have the heroes already to deal with Meepo. Power Gaming, not so much, but... I mean, TNC must have seen their last game, so... To pick Meepo here is just asking them to pick Magnus.
5 seconds. I mean, we saw them lose with the Magnus against the Meepo yesterday, so.
But I mean, you can't go off last game, right? It's different players. And
True.
Different players always means the draft is just completely different. Like, it was an offlane mag, and this time it was a mid lane mag. It's just, you can't really compare the two.
Well, they're banning the Silencer. I think Silencer is definitely the Meepo partner of choice. So they definitely have some. Maybe they're a lot. They're gonna allow the Meepo, but make sure that it's gonna be a tough Meepo game.
I mean, Silence was also like. Actually, wait, they banned it themselves.
Yeah. Oh. Maybe they're thinking about picking Meepo. I don't know who has picks out of the ban phase. I would like to say Power Gaming has it, even though the arrow is pointing the other way.
Oh yeah, yeah. Power Gaming's banned right now.
Check out TA, interesting. So, did they give some sort of like Storm or Shadow Fiend mid? is what I could infer from this.
I think it's just more to do with the fact that they already have a Stardar. They don't exactly want to give TNC the super easy way to kill Roshan.
Okay. I would say that with Stardar alone, that's already enough. But
I mean, Stardar plus TA is just like...
I guess the beauty of that combo so is fast. You could just smoke two heroes in it, and they could just take it themselves.
Yeah, that's also an option. Well, both teams are not showing too much right now. I don't think you can really draw too much from the bans and picks for now.
Well, apart from the fact both that it's a support Slaughter. That's the one thing you could draw from, but that's it.
10 seconds. Carry Slaughter.
Yeah, when's the last time we've seen Carry Slaughter?
I don't even remember. Yeah. Honestly, I think the only team that really liked running it was Reserve Alliance. Time. I think Loda liked playing it. And that's okay. About it.
Venge. I hope this is not a carry Venge. But also, I really personally dislike Dazza and Venge as paired up as a support.
You don't like carry Venge? I think carry Venge is actually really good.
I think carry Venge, whatever she's trying to do, another hero does it better.
5 seconds.
Well, she's the only carry that inflicts a debuff when she dies.
Reserve. Yeah, and you could swap yourself to Sudoku, so I guess. Radiant's pick.
Not a believer.
Nope. If you want to carry that, does something for your team when it dies, Wraith King is a better choice. I'm just saying.
I don't think Wraith King is a better choice.
I mean, if we're just talking about the ult. If you want to carry that has stun, you know, you could take Sven. Or Wraith King, probably. I guess she's the only ranged carry that actually has a stun, right? Alright, thank God she's not playing carry. Dire's pick. Which brings me back to my point where I don't think that Dazzle and Venge is a good support duo together. I feel like these two duo has very, very strong early laning phase, but they don't roam very well, and once a teamfight begins, they're gonna get bullied around so hard by this like teamfight composition of Slaughter Darkseer. And now add Emperor on top of that. I just think they're going to get melted in the fights.
I really like this drop so far from TNC. This Darkseer Ember is going to... In my head, I think it's going to destroy Power Gaming in the early game.
Okay.
It's like nothing. There's very, very little you can do about it.
Yeah, I agree.
5 seconds.
And I don't... really see like a great way of dealing with this. I think Invoker is actually okay here for Power Gaming.
I don't know, we've seen that matchup yesterday, right? Invoker won in the lane, but Ember just shred him afterwards.
Yeah. 10 seconds to go. That I still remember that Veil triple remnant kill.
Yeah. Look, man, I think Power Gaming just meeples here. And pray to the Meeple gods that they could carry this game.
There's no way. I mean, I always joke about, you know, a good Meeple player counters all, but this is
too much.
This is the hardest challenge mode you can ask for to play a Meeple in.
I mean, they don't have like great single target damage. They have a lot of AoE damage, but I believe in Chibi, man.
Oh, I'm trying to think of what their last pick should be, or could be.
For TNC?
Yeah, I think you just want something that can really complement the Slardar Darkseer. After seeing the Ember Spirit, carry Slardar actually isn't so bad either, in my opinion. I think, like, if you were to pick up something like Disruptor, it would be really good in teamfights, but the only downside to it is that they don't really have a good tower hitter right now. So, I mean, if they stick with the support Slardar, they should definitely pick up a core hero that can actually hit buildings.
So, Meepo? I mean, it's not bad for TNC, honestly.
It's not bad at all, yeah. For sure.
But in terms of safe lane that can siege the building, Drow Rangers, on the playing field, although, you know, your lineup is not synergized for it. Oh, so Safelane Ember, I guess. Or you can Safelane Shadow Fiend too, but that's less likely.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Actually, you know, Safelane Shadow Fiend wouldn't even be that bad in this game.
I mean,
because if you assume it's a Timbersaw, right? Like,
yeah.
I mean, actually, to be fair, both of them were actually really good against Timbersaw. But
if you end up SF having, is better. I think SF is much better against Timber.
You can actually kill Timbersaw very easily with the Shadow Fiend.
Like, his burst damage is crazy. Oh! Okay! This is the other kind of cheese, the Huskar cheese. I mean, quite good against Ember, right? Not so good against Slaughter, though. So
it's not good against Slaughter and Shadow Fiend, but that's what the Dazzle is there for.
Like, who's actually going to go mid now against Huskar? Because I don't think either of this hero has a chance.
Shadow Fiend probably has the best chance.
Okay.
Because at least you can you know, raise from a distance to farm.
He's going to just stand on your hill. You're not going to get experience, or at least much of it.
You're going to have to come back off of stacks, as usual.
I think Rubick needs to... I don't know if Rubick could do anything.
No. But, I mean, you have to remember, though, like, if you Dazzle Huskar mid, Slark's Vengeance is going to be very, very vulnerable to a Darkseer Slargar. You're sacrificing quite a bit for this mid matchup to win really, really hard.
Who is sacrificing for the mid matchup?
Power Gaming. Because you're talking about a Huskar mid, right?
Yeah.
A Huskar mid is not going to be enough by himself. He needs the support of either one of them to be there with him.
I don't think so. Maybe for the first level, but that's it. And then you just rope bottom with your other
support. I think you need to be there for longer than just one level. I mean, if you bring over... If it's going to be like Shadow Fiend mid, right? And then you sit either Rubick or the Slardar mid, you're not going to be able to lane against them.
Okay. We shall see. Jacko is going to be our safe lane player? No, he's going mid. Yeah, Chippy's going to playing Slark in the safe lane. And then we got DDZ playing the Timber up top. Dazzle's going there with him. Might stay at top for a bit. May help out mid a bit. We'll see. Whereas TNC is running a very kind of standard lane. The Darkseer plus the Slaughter. Cuckoo's going to be playing the Mid-Shadow Fiend, and then you got Rior protecting Raven up top.
I think for this kind of matchup, a lot of this just really depends on the bottom lane for TNC. Like, the bottom lane is really, really important for TNC.
I think their advantage... All the
other lanes are going to be really difficult for them.
They're advantaged in the bottom lane, right?
Yeah. Well, I mean, that's basically what I've been saying this whole time, right? I really, really believe that if you want this Huskar mid matchup to work, you have to commit a support to winning it.
I disagree, and I think Jacko will win it alone. I mean, I'm gonna watch him just walk up the hill.
Watch.
He's not walking up the hill. There we go. Look. All right, lane one.
I like how Kugri just walks up and denies that creep. He's losing so much life.
Yeah, he's like loses 100 HP. I guess it's worth it because he needs to build his souls. He's got a salve anyways. He's missing uphill. Wow. The RNG is on his side today. Okay, maybe not lane 1 because Jackal's apparently having a tough time. Now Razus gets taken up here. Jackal's going to eat one of them. He doesn't have a salve, so... Man, once he gets that passive... Look at him go, chucking them spears.
Oh. Alright, Cuckoo is holding on to his salve. He's gonna go to the shrine first.
Okay.
Oh, he picks up two salves.
Yo, this is... It's already lane 1, is what I'm saying. Meanwhile, top lane, looks like Raven's having a little bit of a tough time here. 666 harassing quite well. DDZ already level 2, so if the Dazzle wants to leave, he can.
Yeah, just the two of them is not going to be enough. But this bottom lane is really troublesome for the start.
Yeah. Jacko's having a tough time here. He does pick up the boots, so maybe solo kill potential is there. But Cuckoo is keeping his HP up very nicely. I guess this is how you lane against Huskar. Like, it's a terrible matchup, but you just kind of suck it up for a bit and keep buying regen.
I mean, Cuckoo is just doing really, really well abusing the range advantage he has over the Huskar right now. And he just traded away as much health as he could in the early phases.
Yep. He's essentially trading gold for experience, which it's not great, but for Shadow Fiend, that might be all you need. And Cuckoo dropping very low. He's got three spirit burning on him. He needs to pop the Fairy Fire? No, he's fine. He needs to salve again, though, for sure.
Oh, the dive? It's coming in.
Salve got canceled. MTR is going to swing around. Magic Missile is going to hit. And a couple of right clicks will do the job. Fairy Fire turns around. Oh my god, Cuckoo with the place. He levels up to? Oh? Okay, he still dies, but...
I mean, that was...
That was sick.
That was the best scenario you could ask for as a Shadow Fiend.
Yeah.
In that scenario.
That was an absolute outplay by Cuckoo. Well, they're kind of kicking themselves now. And with that, he's actually almost at his bottle. I think once he gets to bottle, the lane gets much better for him.
I mean, Jacko's kind of out of life as well. Jacko... And two levels of the Berserker's Blood is not exactly, like, enough to deal with the raises.
Yeah. You're not impervious with two levels only. Okay, well...
300 life.
I doubted this matchup. I shouldn't have doubted Cuckoo, though. What a player.
Alright, the bottom lane has now become a tri-lane.
How's Slug farming? He's got 12 CS to a Darkseer's 22. Okay. Losing as expected. Ember, though, up top. Losing pretty badly, apparently, to DDZ. Is Ember just jungling? He's, like, pulling and stuff.
It's pretty rough to deal with a Dazzle and a Timber Saw as an Ember Spirit. There's just no way you're going to have enough damage because all you have is a level 1 Ember or Flame Guard or something like that. And then they have a Rubick as a support. There's just no damage for any kind of play to come out.
Yep. Looks like we're going to see another gank party being sent to the mid lane. Cuckoo? How are they going to get in this?
He's got double damage. He's got double damage. They have to be really careful. There's no way this is going to be a thing.
Yeah. Shadow Fiend's got a ward on his side of the hill, so these supports need to be very careful. And they now see Dazzle, so this gank is not going to work out anymore.
I mean, I'm pretty sure this works out for TNC right now, because your Darkseer is just 1v1ing a Slark, and you're not going to... You don't really want that for your Slark. It's really difficult for him. Look, he's struggling so badly. Although he is almost 6, so he does have that going for them, for him.
And Cuckoo is just actually winning this lane now. Like, look at the CS differential. He's actually pulling ahead. Raven up top, dropping extremely low, but tower focusing on DDZ. DDZ is going to go in for the kill. Great pull by Rior. Rior body blocking DDZ a little bit. Tower still going to work here. Another crush by Tims. Magic Missile getting Kaida here, and looks like MTR is going to pick it up with a how. Good play, though. They still kill DDZ first.
Yeah, Cuckoo almost died mid. That was really, really close. Okay. It's just a couple of Burning Spears is all it takes, and all of a sudden, you know,
you have to pace again.
Get destroyed.
Alright, supporting back.
Oh, he's gonna die.
Oh, yeah, he is. And that will be it.
He's
got
the grave. But the grave is so far away!
Yo, the range!
Oh.
Thanks Jacko for the feed.
Is Cuckoo's gonna die? About that one, for sure.
Oh my god, he bottled in between the fire ticks. Gonna survive. Now two kills going to the Shadow Fiend mid. Alright, he's good.
That was just some miscommunication. The Dazzle should have been ready for that, I think.
The Dazzle needed to run forward before the jump even got casted.
I think he should have just graved him as he was jumping in.
I don't know if that grave lasted that long. I mean, you can't blame the Dazzle. It could just be the Huskar just jumped way too fast. And he didn't wait for the Dazzle. But either way, that was some serious miscommunication. Alright, we're going to see a swing around here. TNC is going to find 666, and it looks like he's a little bit asleep on the wheel here. Lift into a easy crush. Shadow Fiend here with the raises. Don't think they can kill Jacko, but they are going to... Whoa, 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 whoa. They are going to just right-click him down. One more is all they need. Tims Gonna go down, but that's gonna give Shadow Fiend a double kill. Cuckoo is just out of control right now.
Yeah, doesn't need the creep farm, and you can farm heroes.
I haven't seen such a disadvantaged matchup being so well played by a player for such a long time, because this era is not an era where just someone outskills and win a game, right? But this is kind of reminding me of it.
And Sam H solo killing the Slark. Also not what you want.
Yep. So is the game over? Like, no jokes, right? Like, you have a Huskar lineup. You're not snowballing. Slark is not getting his Shadow Blade, so he can't snowball in the mid-game. And then your offlane is Timbersaw, who has been doing okay, but also is, you know, die once or twice. Like, what is the comeback mechanism? You're not going to gank your way back because you have Dazzle and Venge as your supports.
Well, the only thing I can say about that is, while that is very true, you should never count out an armlet toggling Dazzle Huskar.
Okay. You just need one of those.
If there's gonna be a way back, it's gonna be off the back of the armlet on the Huskar, and then you're gonna have to wait and see how they play around that.
So it's like a random team fight where like everyone comes in one by one. They think they could kill the Huskar, they don't. Everyone dies.
Easy, he's deep.
Yeah.
Not respecting Raven whatsoever.
Nor the tower.
I mean, he's got 20 stacks. Do you really have to respect anyone with 20 stacks?
Nope. Meanwhile, on the bottom side here, no respect on Chibi either. Chibi's getting chased down here. He's losing HP by doing that. I don't know what the hell about the Dark Pack was.
He was expecting the crush to hit him, that's why.
Meanwhile, Rior...
Either way, he was screwed.
Rior ported back to the fountain and just died. I think Slark went for the wrong build, by the way. I think against Darkseer... And if you're getting run down like this, I think you have to max pounce. Just have better cooldown? Or do you disagree?
I don't agree with that. I think you still take the Dark Pack.
And try to kill the creep wave fast?
If your lane is really this bad... No, it's not even just about that. It's just that... If your lane is really this bad, at least you still have the Dark Pack to go farm in the jungle, or have someone give you a different lane or something like that.
Okay. That's fair.
If you don't have the Dark Pack, like, then it's even worse. Oh, that outplay from Raven.
It seems like TNC is showing that they're perhaps better Dota players. Oh, maybe not here. Tim's in a lot of trouble. Is going to go down here. Raven, regenerating a bit of his mana back up, does have double Remnant, but I don't think that's going to be enough to kill DDZ. This top lane is having all hell of a lot of trouble. Cuckoo rotates in, but just a little bit slow. But he almost has Shadow Blade.
He's got it. Just gonna use up all of his mana, go back to base, farm up a TP, and then go Shadow Blade and kill someone.
Yep. Probably the poor Slark. A
soldier's fortune. Slark finds a invis at the most opportune time. He didn't have ulti too. If the invis rune wasn't there, he was very, very dead.
Alright. Shadow Fiend does have the Shadow Blade and TP, so I wonder where he's gonna go. Probably mid. I don't think they're expecting it. Sentry is very far behind, so probably go for a tower defense. Here comes Cuckoo. Do they want Dazzle first?
They need to kill the Dazzle. Oh, unless this happens.
Okay, raise.
And then you don't even get to respond.
Yep. Dazzle chain is not gonna hit here, but oh my god, the burn. It's just gonna be enough. So the reveal of the Shadow Blade gets two kills by TNC. And now they smoke straight into Roche, I think. Or they're gonna smoke for top. They're pinging him out. Say DDZ, they need to get out of there.
They need to deal with this Timbersaw.
Yeah.
I mean, making him TP away is also like perfectly fine. Means that the top lane will be somewhat safe now.
Yeah. But I mean, yes, Timbersaw is big right now, but I think Shadow Fiend's more than a capable enough of hero to deal with him. Would you disagree?
I mean, if you're talking about just hitting that perfect Requiem, then yeah, it's pretty much gonna instantly kill him. He doesn't have his Bloodstone yet, so he doesn't exactly have the HP pool to survive that.
Well, I guess what I'm trying to say is that the way that Cuckoo is scaling right now, he is gonna be able to pick up damage item and right-click him through reactive armor in the late game.
Oh yeah, definitely. I mean, even without the right-click damage, just raises and Requiem alone, he should be more than enough to deal with Timbersaw.
Yeah, right now. He is the highest net worth. Cuckoo is.
Chibi.
By the way, Rubick has life break. Are we going to see that happening here? No. Not worth his time. Tim's gonna walk up the hill here, and well, they actually just get off the crush here. Are we gonna life break him? No, Rior is dead. Rior might as well life break for Rior dies. No, he's still actually weave. Nice back wall here, pretty decent. Now they're gonna focus on Jacko. Jacko does die to the wall. 66 is gonna be dead. He's gonna grave himself. Meanwhile, Cuckoo hangs around to see if any backup is coming. All right, 2-4 in exchange. That was a good back wall combo.
Yeah, I mean, it's. I think I mentioned this at the start. The only thing I remember them from WSG is, like, they really, really play well around these, like, combo heroes.
Mm-hmm.
So Darkseer into pretty much anything, they do really, really well.
Are we gonna see the perfect VAC into Requiem this game?
Okay, maybe. Okay, that's, like, a lot more difficult.
That's super hard to do.
Set up.
Yeah. I mean, Slaughter Crush could, you know, tie it together. Alright, MTR is... I'm pretty sure Shadowfiend could just like walk up with him, Shadow Blade, hit him once, and double raise. Oh,
they see him walking over.
Oh, baby. Alright.
They even give him the kill.
Tim's what a support player. Mid lane?
Straight to mid?
Yo, he's not afraid. He might, okay.
Actually, vacuum.
Vacuum back in. Oh, man. And they're both dead. You said it's a little bit too hard. Maybe not so much. Cuckoo dropping low, but now Veil onto DDZ. DDZ's also dead.
Oh, and that was a Rubick triple kill.
With what? Whirling Death?
Yeah, right clicks? One. I mean, it shreds strength heroes, right?
I guess.
He only did 600 damage that team fight, but it was enough to snag him 3 kills.
Yeah. Kill secured, and now they go into Roche. Man, this is like watching one team just heavily outclass another team.
And a lot of pings coming out, but do you really have an answer for this? I don't think so. No lockdown whatsoever on Power's side. It's just Avenge.
Yep.
That's one of the biggest... I think that it would be actually one of the biggest issues they have with their draft, is that they only have Avenge for disables, and... If you only have Avenge for disable, like, how are you ever going to kill this Ember Spirit?
She's actually not leveling up
so many items.
It's just a 1.2 second stun right now. I guess leveling up wouldn't add too much of it, but, you know, again, this being their only stun.
I think the only way you can actually lock down the Ember Spirit is if, like, your Slark goes for an Orchid build.
He almost has enough to finish Shadowblade. Sorry for missing this one. DBZ still being effective despite how poorly the game's going, but Cuckoo now sees 666. Is he gonna go for him? Oh no, just the break here. Okay, now back in here, and the Fable is gonna get one kill. That's a second, that's a third.
Really unfortunate for this Dazzle. Like, you picked the Dazzle and the Huskar, and I don't think I've ever seen a Huskar fight underneath
Grave, yeah. Grave.
I mean, agree. You look at the fight recap, and Dazzle didn't even get to cast a single spell.
I mean, a part of it is him being very underlevel. Part of it, the fact that, like, even if you Grave the Huskar now, like he's broken, right, by the Silver Edge. It looks like solo kill here on Chibi. I could see why this team won WESG, because they are playing like a well-oiled machine right now.
Cuckoo. Trying to find DDZ, but DDZ smartly walks towards his tower.
What do you think Shadowfiend is going to build next?
BKB?
Damage?
Hurricane Pike?
How about like something like a Manta?
No.
No Manta?
I don't think you need a Manta here. Okay. Probably just go for BKB or Hurricane Pike or something like that.
I mean, I think we played a couple of games together where I play Shadow Fiend and I just cannot itemize properly. Like, this is the one hero that I just don't have a feel for.
Yeah, that's, I mean, Okay, he has Manta.
Okay, you don't know shit, son.
I don't know anything about Shadow Fiend.
Actually, I don't. I'm not sure if Manta's that good, honestly. Now that I heard your disagreement about it, I mean, he's probably gonna make the Manta work because he's so far ahead.
Yeah, there is that.
I mean, I think they're just gonna go straight to high ground, right? Like, what's stopping them? Maybe they're gonna go safety and take the tier 2 first. That seems to be the case.
They do get weaved up, so you might as well wait it out.
Yeah. Jackal stands menacingly. He's like, I'm a Huskar, dude. Alright, they'll back it up, I think. Or I guess he could just go, like, Dragonlance. It's always good.
I mean, he's already finished his Yasha.
Alright, Blink Crush here. Where's the back? Back okay, wall's gonna be there, 6 and 6. Did get his grave off, and right now he is completely committed. Jackal, once the grave runs out, he's dead. And now we're gonna jump forward. Ember gets a two-man chain. Venge is dead.
Tower's dead, all three of them are dead.
Yeah. High ground time? Okay, Slaughter is thinking about going a kill on DBZ, but it's like, nah. Let's not worry about that. Cuckoo still has Aegis, by the way.
I was actually gonna say, I would have liked to see Scepter after the Yasha. You just get a Yasha just so you can move around quickly, and then you pick up the Scepter.
I mean, he's approaching the talent point, right? Oh, not 20 yet, but they're gonna just get the Rex.
I mean, at the rate this game is going, I mean, he'll probably finish Manta and then still be able to finish the Scepter by level 20.
Oh, you know what's an interesting idea? If he went for Helm of Dominator. Right? Oh, hold on, dog here. Cuckoo? Gonna just come out and kill people. Look at the grave, do you work? I think the fire is gonna burn him down regardless, but he still has Aegis. He'll respawn. Alright. The question is what he's gonna do after he respawns. Shackles to the middle of the back. It's gonna be good to crush! Oh my god, they're all dead. Savage picks up a triple. Alright, I've been talking about Cuckoo a lot, but I think Samage is probably the unsung hero of this match. Vacuum, always on point, always perfect, always hitting 2-3, at least.
I'm telling you, these combination plays from TNC are what you have to look out for. They're just... They, like, never miss it, honestly.
Yeah.
I in the last 10 matches, I've watched them play or something like that. Like, they're just so good about this.
And that was... That caught us right back up on time. We're gonna take a short break, guys. Game 2 is on the way, and TNC is looking really, really hot.